Hi, my name is Pedro, and this is All My Function. This is the video number 5 of a series I'm creating to teach you about data visualization. If you didn't check them out before, please go and watch them right now. This video is going to be to explain groups in SVGs and HTML in general. So, right, usually you separate your code in divs, or if you use React, you separate them in fragments, so you have things separated logically in your code. On SVGs, we have something called groups that are the tag G inside of the SVG, and it's very important for you to understand this concept because you're going to use it to separate our chart when we create our own charts using D3 or visx or any other library. Let's see how it works. Right, so here we have a basic bar chart that has a Y and an X axis and has all the bars. So think about groups. You have to think that each one of these parts is actually a group. So this thing here is a group. So the Y axis is a group. The X axis is actually a group. And the bars are actually a group. Then you can separate them and you can actually check them separated on your code so they make more sense, and in the end you can put them together on any chart. And the nice thing about it is that, for example, I can create a chart that is not actually a bar chart. So this is the bar chart, but I can create one that is I don't know, like a line chart here. Stroke this. So you can separate the code like this, and it's going to be way easier for you to create new charts in the future. I know that if you are a software engineer for a long time and you're learning data visualizations now, you already know this concept, but that's really important for people that is starting to learn web development right now and they don't know how to separate their code. And I think that it helps everyone to get a literal reminder of what we should do. I hope you like it, and let's see it implemented on the next video. See you soon. Bye bye.